how do you get prepared to get a chemical peel done? The first thing is that you go and consult a dermatologist. If you think that you have some indication for getting a chemical peel done, maybe pigmentation, maybe dull looking skin, maybe acne, and you think that you would benefit from a chemical peel, the first thing is speak to a dermatologist. These people are qualified to understand what is the need of the skin, and they will give you something called a skin prep. A skin prep contains of those medicines like glycolic acid, like retinols, which will help to exfoliate the upper layer of the skin so that the chemical peel, when it's applied, it penetrates evenly throughout the skin, so you get much better results. The doctors may also advise you to use a good moisturizer and a sunscreen. This will prevent any damage happening to the skin by the chemical peel inadvertently. What is the procedure of a chemical peel? A chemical peel is a fairly straightforward outpatient dermatology procedure. The day that you have the chemical peel, the doctor will advise you to come without applying any makeup, apply only your sunscreen and go to the clinic. When you reach the clinic, the doctor observes your skin to understand once again what are the concerns which you are presented with. Then the makeup or the sunscreen is removed with a cleanser, and then a peel is applied all over the face and neck or on the affected area. Usually chemical peels are neutralized within 10 minutes, but there are some chemical peels which are left on for a few hours. Then the chemical peel is washed with water or a neutralizer solution. At the end of the neutralizing, there is a stinging sensation which is felt, and then a moisturizer is applied followed by a broad spectrum sunscreen. What do you expect after your first chemical peel? Usually the first chemical peel is a very gentle chemical peel, a superficial chemical peel, and with this treatment you are going to experience some stinging during the treatment. Post treatment there might be a mild redness over some areas which should reduce within 12 to 24 hours. Very rarely there might be some dryness or scabbing or exfoliation which follows the chemical peel. For this, the dermatologist usually prescribes a gentle face wash, which will be a soap-free, non-foaming face wash, and the use of a hyaluronic acid or a moisturizer, which is quite thick and which will help the dryness from irritating your skin too much. Definitely, you will have to use a sunscreen and avoid sun exposure for the next 24 to 48 hours. And in case of medium depth peels or deeper peels which have lots of exfoliation, you might be asked to stay out of the sun for a whole week. During the time of exfoliation, there might be some scabs which are formed, which usually look like this. And these scabs can be irritating to the skin, but remember that it is the process of the healing of the skin itself. So do not try and pick at it or peel it off or rub your skin. Avoid using any scrubs. Avoid using any retinol creams or glycolic acid creams unless your doctor advises you to restart them. For the first 3 to 4 days after the chemical peel, please make sure that you are following the instructions of the dermatologist very strictly. If you do notice that the scabs are more than what your dermatologist has advised you about, go back to your dermatologist so they can explain to you how to take care of this dryness or peeling in a better way. How often are chemical peels repeated? Chemical peels are repeated depending on the nature of the chemical peel itself. If you are doing very superficial chemical peels like glycolic or salicylic acid peels, they can be repeated fortnightly. Trichloroacetic peels, retinol peels are usually repeated only once a month because they do cause a lot of exfoliation. The skin has to return to normal before a second peeling session can be done. Usually 6 to 8 treatments are needed for the complete improvement of a treatment area which is being addressed. If you want to know more about chemical peels and if to know if you are a great candidate for chemical peels, speak to your dermatologist today.